Hi everyone, my name is Nuno. Welcome to this series of tutorials on how to program SkyDust. If you want to know how to program a synthesizer, so this is a series of videos precisely for that. On the first session, we talked about oscillators. Now let's talk about envelope generators. So what we're going to do once again is we're going to start with this init basic sign, this red template that we have, preset that we have in here, okay? And this, of course, will give you a very dull kind of sound with only one oscillator. But now let's talk about envelope generators. As the name tells you, this is what going to generate the envelope of the sound. So how do you want the sound? Do you want the sound to start attacks very fast or go slowly growing up and then it does it go away or holds up until you release the note? It's almost like the difference, okay, when you have an ARP that, okay, you get an attack but then pretty much decays automatically until reaches almost silence, and then you get something like an organ or a trumpet where pretty much you hold the note. So let's see how you do all of this. At SkyDust, we have envelope generators for a lot of things. You can use envelope generators for gain, for filters, for pitch, for spatial, and many other things. For now, let's talk about gain. That is, once again, the basic model that you're going to do. So, once again, we have here, let's put some triangle instead. And now let's move here for this oscillator one page for you to get this envelope generator. So I have this envelope generator. There are multiple flavors of envelope generators. SkyDust has a few of them, but usually 90%+ of the times people simply use this ADSR, that pretty much it's the initial letter of attack, decay, sustain and release. And pretty much this means that when we are using a synthesizer, you're going to have almost something like this. So you have this attack time, so the note starts from zero, starts to grow up until it reaches this peak, this attack peak. Then after reaching this peak, it's going to decay, okay, until you get to this sustain point, and then the note will hold in this sustain point, and then when you release the note is released, and you get this kind of releasing this fade out of the note. So pretty much something like this. Okay, of course here I have very slow times. I'm on the sustain and then when I release, it starts to decay. So what we are going to do on the envelope generator, in this case, this is the envelope generator that controls the gain of oscillator one. That's why it's here on the oscillators and here on this oscillator one tab. So let's start by the attack time. So the attack time says, okay, how long does it take for the sound to reach this peak? For instance, if I have a very fast, okay, so attacks very fast, in this case, it's go almost directly to the maximum value. Of course, if I go to the opposite and play the note, let me just put it like this. Okay, I play the note, and then the note starts to grow very slow before starting to decay. And of course, most of the times we don't want either a very, very fast attack nor a very slow. Of course, if you are doing things like a pad or a strings, probably you want a slow attack, not as slow as this. We don't need 5 seconds to build up. It could be a second, half a second, something like that. It's still slow. Or eventually you may want some in-between values. Okay. So we have the attack time, how much do you want this to go to the maximum level. Then, of course, we have the peak. Once again, it's a timing. You say, okay, how much time it's going to take to decay. So you could say, no, I want this to decay quite fast also. Okay, let's put sustain at zero for you to more easily understand this. Okay, or eventually imagine that now I want the decay to be slightly more slow. Okay, could be even slower. or could be quite fast. And okay, then finally we have this sustain. While with attack, decay and release, pretty much we would define the timings. Sustain, what we do is we define the level where we want the note to sustain. So pretty much in this case we are pretty much controlling the times, okay, of until attack, until release. With sustain we are adding the level. So pretty much what happens is that if I put this on the maximum value, I'm not going to have any sort of decay. I attack and reach that attack time and stay there, something like this. Okay, no decay whatsoever. If I want a slight decay, I could have an in-between value and then olds, or eventually I can eventually have a sound that, okay, I don't want any kind of sustain whatsoever. Where the note is finished, is finished. Okay, and then finally we're going to have the release. Okay, so if you want the sound to, when I stop the note, ends quite dramatically. Okay, completely finishes, but a lot of time we want some kind of fade out, and you get this kind of fade out of the note. So pretty much we have these three controls, once again, attack time, decay time, the sustain level and the release time, and we can do this to control the oscillator. Of course you can think about this, about having the global envelope of the sound, but the interesting thing is that when you start using more than one oscillators, this can be used not only to control the overall sound, but actually the timbre. What do I mean? Well, imagine that we have two oscillators that are completely different. So let's in here have oscillator one, let's put a square, okay? Okay, let's put this with very fast attack. Okay, so I have here a square, fast attack and relatively fast decay. But now imagine that I'm going to add a second waveform, okay, that is not a square, it's a much more mellow, for instance, a triangle, okay? But now I start increasing the attack and decay, okay, and you get, of course, this is completely out. So what we want to do is, okay, let's use a square with a lot of brightness that attacks, okay, but pretty much goes away. But then as this goes away, you continue having the triangle. So pretty much we are not only controlling the volume, the overall volume of this sound, but we are also controlling timbre, because we want, okay, let's use this oscillator with a lot of brightness only for the attack, and then keeping on the remaining of the note, we're going to have a more mellow kind of sound. So let's, for instance, doing something like this. So as you can see, with this example, once again, we have here a square and a triangle, okay? And we have, what we're going to do is, you have the square pretty much attacks but then goes away, and then what you get, it's only the sound of the triangle that continues there. Okay, or eventually, once again, if you consider this, that imagine that you're going to have the triangle, for instance, with a lower kind of sound, what is going to happen is this. So a lot of things that envelope generators can help you. Yes, of course, they control the overall gain, the overall volume of the note. But when you start having different kinds of envelope generators associated with different oscillators, we can also start using this to control the timbre and make sure that the timbre slightly changes through time, and that's it's an interesting approach of using envelope generators. On the upcoming videos, you're going to see how envelope generators can be used for other things, regarding filters, pitch, spatial and other things. But you need to know that envelope generators is a fantastic tool that helps you doing things. I'm just going to show you here the most complicated one, because if you understand this, you're going to understand all of them. So pretty much what we have here, as you can see, there are two additional parameters. We have the delay and the hold. And what happens in here is that we start to have a delay. Eventually you may want an oscillator that comes later on, after the others are already start to play. Of course, we have the attack that you already know. We have the decay and the sustain and the release, but there is another one that is the hold. So pretty much it's like a initial sustain, and then you have a decay and have a second sustain, and this will give you a different kind of sound that you may want to use. The next video, we're going to talk about filters, and so see you in the next video.